Good morning, my dear students. I am going to start my 14th lecture on heat transfer by conduction. So today I am going to continue use of temperature, use of transient temperature charts, that is Heisler charts. Okay, this is very important. And last class I discussed about the lumped system analysis. When the Biot number is less than 1, less than 0.1, how to solve the problem by using, if the Biot number is less than 0.1, using the temperature distribution equation at time t divided by theta t divided by theta is equal to e to the power of mt. On these two equations, by analyzing the value of Biot number which is less than 0.1, then you have to use a lumped system analysis for any application. It means any transient heat conduction with variation in time. So the another problem is that the variation of temperature with position and time both you have to analyze. Previously, only with the time you have analyzed. Now we have the using a one more variable, that position and time, by using a transient temperature charts, that is Heisler charts or Grover charts. Okay. So now, in many situations, the temperature gradient in the solids is no longer negligible, because hence the lumped system analysis is no longer applicable. It means if you are not neglecting the temperature gradient, then lumped system analysis not possible to apply. If you consider the temperature gradient exist, then you have to apply the position and time both in that condition. Then you have to analyze the problem by going to see the Biot number which is greater than 0.1, then you have to use this Heisler charts. Okay, the Biot number also, the definition I was last class I given, and it is given in the page number 58, that is HL by KS. Biot number is equal to HL by K. So this is L is for slab, if it is dealt, D is for cylinder and sphere. Okay, go to the next slide. For slab, consider a slab of thickness 2L. Already I have given this topic discussion in the yesterday class. Until this point I discussed, you know, this geometric coordinate and boundary conditions of transient heat conduction in slab is given. And one case is that this case you are considering the, in this case, you are considering the center as 0 and to the left negative coordinate, and it is to the right it is a positive coordinate. So the convection heat transfer to the wall and then getting conducted to the wall. So convection from the air and conducted to the wall. So similarly, the whatever the heat is conducted or to be convected out from the other surface initially at a temperature T0 or T1. Ti you can take. Okay, in the another boundary condition is when the temperature gradient never exists at this point and how the boundary conditions are to be taken. There are two cases I considered, and these two cases I am going to analyze. So dimensionless equation you have to write, and in the examination these dimensionless equation not going to be asked. Okay, this is of not importance for the, only for analyzing the equation, which are the equations used for plotting the Heisler charts, those equations are given here. So this is d square t by dx square is equal to 1 by alpha dt by dx, where alpha is the thermal diffusivity, and which is in the range of 0 less than x less than L for time greater than 0. This is one equation, and dt by dx is equal to 0. That previously I have shown dt by dx is equal to boundary condition at x is equal to 0, t is greater than 1. This is one condition, this is second condition. Third condition is using convective boundary condition and at x is equal to l, t is greater than 0 and t is equal to t1. These are the four general conditions I have taken for analyzing the problem. Okay. So and the temperature distribution, dimensionless coordinate, and Biot number and Fourier number. These are the quantities required for calculating the time domain or position domain, whatever you want in the problem. Okay. So these are the equation that we are going to use. Same can be for in different version the Biot number. All the equations which are above is converted into partial differential equation with time zone and also position, and they are look similar. So what are the charts that you are going to refer? Go to the page number in the data handbook. The values of the error function is also given in page number 60. If you are using error function, this is page number 60. If at all I am using this, I am going to refer the page number and then I am going to plot over it. See, another thing is that temperature distribution for the semi-infinite solid with convective boundary condition, it is not included in your syllabus. Don't worry about that also. Go to the page number 66. Note down the page number 66. There is an infinite plate. Temperature time history at the middle plane. Middle of the middle plane means you have seen this is the middle plane. This is the middle plane and this is the boundary condition at the end. It means at x is equal to 0, dt by dx is equal to 0. Transient heat conduction charts for a slab. So the equation 4.9, A and D has been solved result of the dimensionless temperature presented in figure 4.AB and dimensionless heat transfer as a function of dimensionless time for several different value of Biot number for a slab is thickness of 2L as shown in 4.8. These are the graphs which are shown for what reason. So, I don't think graphs are there. 1 minute. Know what happened to the graph. See, anyhow, the graphs are given in the data handbook. I am going to show you that. Just look at this. This is the one graph. This graph is Fourier's number with respect to the temperature distribution. It means the time history at the mid plane, it's going to be taken. Page number 60 and figure number, he has not given any figure number here. Page number 66, the graph is there. That is time history at mid plane. And page number 67, it is the time history at any position x. This is one. Second one is time history at any position x. That is a temperature time history. This is a temperature. This is also temperature versus time history at any position x. That's given there. And another one is there. Another one more graph, that is page number 70. It is the heat flow for a finite plate. Another one is there. Page number 66, this is in 67, and one more is there, 68. that is heat flow infinite plate. So the three graphs I am going to use for transient temperature charts, that's what I given, and the numbering, but I not taken this on the slide, but it is given in the data handbook. You have to refer them, page number 66, 67, 68. These three graphs, one is time history with respect to the mid plane, and time history with respect to the position, and heat flow with respect to the infinite plate. Okay, those graphs are taken to solve the problem. So now let us take one example to solve the problem. A 5 cm thick iron plate, conductivity 60 watt per meter degree Celsius, and coefficient of at constant pressure, CP value 460 joule per kilo kg per degree Celsius, kilojoule per kg degree Celsius, and density is 7850 kg per meter cube, and alpha thermal diffusivity 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter square per second, is initially at a temperature of 225 degree, and suddenly both the surfaces are exposed. Suddenly, both surfaces are exposed to ambient air at 25 degree with a heat transfer coefficient of 500 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Calculate the center temperature at the time t equal to 2 minute after the start of cooling, and calculate the temperature at the depth of 1 centimeter from the surface at time t is equal to 2 minute after the start of cooling. Okay, and also third condition, calculate the energy removed from the plate per square meter during this time. So these are the data given, and these are the conditions mentioned here. When the center temperature after 2 minutes, and depth of 1 centimeter, what is the temperature after 2 minutes, and another thing is energy removed per square meter during this time. So three conditions are asked. I am going to solve this problem by using Hazelak charts. Before that, what you have to do is, but you have to calculate the value of Wyatt number, whether it is greater than 0.1 or less than 0.1, for applying the which condition, either you have to use a lumped system analysis or the Hazelak chart to calculate the time and position, and also the energy removed from the system. Okay. I'll take 1 minute to reload and show the graphs also. I'll reload another previous slide presentation I'm taking. Same thing is there. Yeah, I've taken okay, anyhow, the coming example, I'm going to show the Hazelak charts, how the charts be referred by, also given the charts, how to refer those things there. So now we have to calculate the L value. What is the thickness is gone? 5 centimeters gone. 2L is equal to how much? 5 centimeter. 2L. This is the solution. 2L is equal to 2 into 5. This in centimeter.
This you have to convert that into meter. So how much you get? 10 into 10 raised to minus 2.
2.5. 2L. This is 2L.
So therefore L is equal to del earth. Value is 5 is given. 2L value itself is 5 centimeter and divided by 100 is 10 raised to minus 2. So this is equal to 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter.
This is what the value you get, because total thickness is given. Thickness is 5 centimeter iron plate. So mid-plane problem is given. As per the geometry, you have to calculate. First, you have to calculate the tau. Tau is from Fourier's number. Fourier's number can be calculated by using the equation here. Fourier's number after calculation is 3.1. So, Fourier's number is alpha t by L square.
Fourier's number is equal to alpha t by L square.
So, time domain is given. So, alpha is 1.6. into 10 raised to minus 5
into 2 into 60, 2 minutes into 60 per second you have to get. This is 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 2.
So this is 2 minutes into 60 seconds. Okay, that total value you get 3.1. Fourier's number is equal to 3.1. Then from figure, so you will have to go Fourier, the Biot number you have to calculate, and x by l. From the figure, we have to calculate this. I think it is very small in number. Go to page number 66. So, for a Biot number of 4.3, calculate the Biot number. First, you have to calculate the Biot number. And what will be the value of Biot number you have to, whether this is applicable or not. First you have to calculate the Biot number. Biot number is equal to HL by K. H value that he has given. What is the value of H is given? Just you have to take it. 500
into 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 2 divided by
the conductivity value that he has given is 60.
So probably, and this if you do it, you will get always it is greater than 0.1.
So therefore, so lumped system analysis cannot be applied. If you calculate, you will greater than 0.1. Therefore, I have taken the temperature charts for calculating the position and time with respect to this. So now you have to calculate 1 by Biot. Biot number already calculated, and how much is that Biot number? That you have to calculate.
So this value you have to take 1 by Biot. This is equal to 4.8 you get.
So similarly, x by L is 0.6. From figure, the temperature T naught can be calculated by using this. So how do you take this? I am going to show it in the graph which I have plotted. See, hints that I have given, this is the, for determining the dimensionless quantity for x by L and q by naught, and Eisler chart is to be used. Okay, so this is for Fourier, and 1 by Biot how we have calculated by using a Eisler chart for the mid-plane problem. How I am going to take this? See, after calculating Biot number from this,
you have to take 1 by Biot is equal to 4.8,
and there is a graph for that. In page number 68, you have to take Biot number and one by Byatt. There are different graphs are given here. I have followed different graph. So any of the procedure is remain same. So take temperature distribution is equal to 0.58 and the Fourier number is equal to 3.1, where it intersect. R, first you have to take 1 by Byatt line and Fourier number is equal to 3.1. For what I calculated, first Byatt number I have taken. This is a Byatt number line. Okay, 1 by Byatt number. In this Kodan-Raman, directly Byatt number is given. Here I have taken 1 by Byatt, inverse of that. And Fourier number I calculated 3.1. So from the, this is a graph which looks like, in that Fourier number 3.1 you have to take here, where it intersect with the 1 by Byatt of 4.8, this is the line of 4.8, and there you have to take the temperature distribution, T naught minus T infinity, Ti minus T infinity, directly it is given in this graph. You can directly take that temperature distribution graph. So this graph I am telling you. Directly you can see this graph. So these red lines indicates the Fourier, this one Byatt number lines. Okay, these Byatt number lines, can you see this? This graph I am using, that is temperature distribution versus Fourier number. So this is the graph, little hint I made, and this temperature distribution is taken. So where I have taken this temperature distribution, directly I have taken here. I think, well, does it belong to the same problem or something you have copied extra? How much is the value I got? 0.55 now. The other example I have taken, but it should be 0.95 for this problem, and 0.95 only I have taken. Here 0.95 I have taken. From that you are going to calculate the temperature Ti. So that temperature should be 135.2 degrees Celsius after the something extra it is uploaded here. I'm not able to catch up. I think this is overlapped. This graph is not, this is 0.55. From that you have to calculate temperature. Again, x by l, position, at what position is asked, no? Second case. So this is 0.95 and temperature 135.2. Okay, here I have taken that, forget about previous slide, and temperature is 135.2 you are going to get. Heat lost from the plate, it means the temperature distribution only calculated with Fourier number and Byatt number. So you're taking 1 by Byatt is equal to 4.8, x by l is equal to 0.6 from figure. It means from figure, which figure you are referring here is page number 67, you have to refer that x by l value, and then you have to calculate the x by value appropriately. X by value, x by l is 0.6, here is the 0.6 graph. So this one 0.6 line, from this line and the Byatt number line you have to calculate the temperature distribution. Almost temperature distribution will get 0.95 in the this axis. Here the temperature distribution value is 0.96, you have to take here, and from that you have to calculate the temperature T. That work out to be 135 degrees Celsius. Heat loss by the from the plate per square meter, including both sides during the transient up to 2 minutes, is determined as, again you have to calculate the Byatt number 0.21, which is greater than 0.1, and Byatt squared into Fourier's number. This you have to take from the third chart. From the graph which is given from page number 68, go to page number 68 and this graph. Okay, all graphs may be look similar, but I have not taken this graph. Next class I am going to take that graph. I am going to solve exclusively by taking the same graph only and show it in the, because we are referring this data handbook, means you have to take the data from this data handbook only. You have to solve this, but one problem I am trying to solve from this data handbook only. This is one of the exam problem I solved. So there you will get the temperature, the heat flow, ratio of heat flow, that you are going to get this 0.45 from this graph. Here 0.45 you are going to get, 0.45 on this axis you are going to get. So that I have taken here by analyzing the Biot number and Biot number into Fourier's number, and in the x value, this is the Biot number value, and this is the x coordinate, and on the y coordinate referring this. So from this MCP delta T rho 2L area into Cp into Ti minus T infinity, you have to take, convert that into a energy equation. From this you are going to calculate by substituting all the values of density, and it is the Cp value and the length and area. You have to substitute all this, and then you have to calculate the what is the amount of energy lost during a 2 minutes period. That is how we are going to calculate. That is 35.33 into 10 raised to 6 joules. Then the heat loss from the slab per square meter in 2 minutes, you have to calculate. That you have to multiply Q by Q naught is equal to 4.5 of Q, and you will get this much, 15.9 into 10 raised to 6 joule. Okay, I'll go to the next problem probably, and these are the two plots how I have taken Q naught. So this is a Biot into Fourier line, and Biot number of 0.25. You have to take the Q distribution value. It means the energy distribution value here, the ratio of energy lost from the slab, and this is the position, x by L position, from where we are taking x by L is equal to 0.6, and then 0.98 you will get, and this is how we have to take. So if you probably you try and then solve this problem, whatever the method I given. So I'm sorry, and this is the graph I have taken, and this graph is totally different from the graph which I have taken here. So this is the middle position, slab, and you are taking x minus L and x, this is positive coordinator and negative ordinate and positive ordinate. You will get L is equal to minus L and plus L is equal to 2L. 2L means 5 centimeter thickness is given, divided by 2 I am taking, and also I calculating Biot number. After that I am going to calculate the 1 by Biot is equal to K by H theta. These are all 1 by Biot line. These are all the, these lines which are shown here are 1 by Biot number. This is Fourier number, and this is the temperature distribution. That is what I used here. So this is something else has patched here, but I could not able to look at that. And this is 1 by Biot is equal to 4.8. Directly X by L is taken. Before that, you have to calculate the temperature distribution after 2 minutes. So the X by L value is showing here, and there's a mistake. So this is the temperature at after 2 minutes at a distance of 0.1 centimeter. So then I have to take the temperature, that is the heat lost from this slab after 2 minutes, and these are the hints I have given. Okay, these are the charts which I referred at the mid plane. This is one chart, that is a time temperature history with the time at the mid plane, and this is the position on temperature history at what position you want by calculating the 1 by Biot number. And you have to calculate X by L value, and then take the temperature distribution, and then calculate the initial temperature of that at a distance. This is the another graph which gives the dimensionless heat transfer for the slab of thickness 2L, taking the Biot number and Fourier's number into Biot number, Biot square into Fourier's number, and the dimensionless heat transfer for a slab of thickness 2L. So you can see this, I think I don't know what is the indicator, indicator is not, okay, now it's coming. Position position correction for the wall, it means a transient temperature chart for a slab of 2L and subjected to convection boundary condition and 2L value. So that is X by L value you are going to take. So I'll solve one more problem, and probably I may make a justification on this. Consider a long cylinder. See, here one thing you have to remember, cylinder, sphere and also slab are having a similar graphs. First graph is time history, second graph is position, third graph is the non-dimensional heat transfer. Three graphs you have to refer consistently, and then you have to solve the problem. See, using a transient temperature charts, dimensionless transient temperature distribution and heat result similar to those given in figure number, whatever shown the graph, similar to that only, cylinder and sphere that you have to take. Consider one dimensional transient heat conduction for a long cylinder of radius r, which is initially at a uniform temperature Ti, suddenly which is cooled or exposed to the boundary condition where the temperature is very low at time t is equal to 0, and what happens after a certain time t is greater than 0. The mathematical formulation for this time duration also given like this, and you don't have to worry about that. It is only for calculation purpose you have shown like this. That is dimensionless temperature, dimensionless coordinate, and Biot number and Fourier number. All these numbers are related to this partial differential equation with respect to the, first with respect to the temperature, with respect to the boundary condition, with the temperature gradient, and with respect to the time, and when the temperature is zero at one specified location. So time t, these are all the time domain, greater than zero, greater than zero, greater than zero are taken. So why you are taking the time? Because how fast it's going to cool, whether the temperature gradients are negligible in a system or not, when it is started cooling or when it started heating. When it cools, how long it will take to reach the steady state. That is the condition that you have to determine. But in this transient temperature charts, the temperature gradients are not negligible at any given point of time. Only a specified temperature, you can see how much energy is lost to the system, how the temperature is going to be calculated from a specified location to the specified location, at a specified location from the initial condition. That is what you have to study. So the temperature T0 at the center of the cylinder, it means center of the slab you have studied, now at the center of the cylinder, how the Eisler chart is going to be plotted. See, these are the graphs plotted by 1 by Biot. So this is 1 by Biot number line, and this is Fourier temperature, Fourier number. What is that Fourier number always you are talking about? This is the time domain calculation it's going to give, because it is having alpha t by, see, it's diffusivity into time divided by r square, I think. Alpha t by r naught, yes. R naught is the initial radius at that point. It's very difficult to enlarge this and then show you. This is one graph that I am going to refer, and this is the position correction chart that you are going to refer for 1 by Biot, and this is R by R naught that you are going to study here. Thereby X by L you are going to study for this lab, here R by R naught you are going to, and the temperature history you are going to study here. So this is again the non-dimensional heat transfer for a long cylinder of radius r is equal to r naught, and this is Biot number line, and this is a Fourier Biot square into Fourier number. This is the dimensionless transient dimensionless heat transfer coordinate. Okay, transient temperature chart for sphere, it looks similar when the time is zero and time is greater than one, and we are going to study all these things. Again, using four numbers, and this is how the time temperature, the temperature at the center of the sphere using Eisler chart. How do you calculate the temperature distribution? This is one graph, and I'm just showing what is available in the data handbook. And don't worry about it. And you can go to the page number. These are all given in page number 60, 65, 66, 67, 68 for slab, and for cylinder 69. 70 and 71. For sphere, the page number 72, 73 and 74. So, right from 66 to 74, the graphs are given for slab, cylinder and sphere. All the three graphs. It means first one is temperature distribution with respect to the time, temperature distribution with respect to the position, and the heat flow with respect to the time. All the three graphs are specifically given in the data handbook. You have to take the appropriate values, and using these Heisler charts, you can calculate whatever value you want. Okay, whatever the variables that he has asked in the numerical example. Suppose I am going to start with this. I may take this opportunity to make justification. Previous problem, that is overlapping, is there, could not able to clearly tell you. And take one more problem, and long cylinder. I am going to make justification in this. A long aluminum cylinder of radius 10 cm, which is initially at a uniform temperature, initial means TI, 350 degrees Celsius, is suddenly exposed to the environment. See, no, any problem we take, it is where it is having a very high temperature or at a low temperature, and suddenly exposed to the atmosphere, and what will be the variation in temperature and temperature distribution and with respect to the time that you are going to see. Okay, in this problem, suddenly exposed to the environment at 30 degrees. It means the aluminum cylindrical rod is, cylinder is already at 350 and exposed to 30 degrees. What is the convection heat transfer coefficient between cylinder surface and the environment is 1000 watt per meter square Kelvin. Determine the time required for axis of cylinder to attain the temperature of 126 degrees Celsius. Determine the time required for the axis of radius or the axis of the cylinder to attain a temperature of 126. It means at the center. And what will be the center temperature after the time required to attain this temperature? Time domain you have to calculate. Okay. So the conductivity value is given 204. Because aluminum, it is not mentioned in this. See, what you do if it is aluminum cylinder is not mentioned, means you have to take from the data handbook, and what is the aluminum that the data, how I have taken this is from the property value of standard metals, property value of insulating metal. But in this book, go to property value of a material, common materials, page number 14, page number 12 to, so specifically aluminium is given page number 10. So the aluminium, there are varieties of aluminium is given 2024 and tempered 351. Aluminium's values are given, and I have taken 204. So especially you have to refer this variation of thermal conductivity, some alloy with the temperature, and aluminium alloy I have taken 204 and directly from the data handbook at 350 degree Celsius. Okay, that is the property I have taken from that, and also I have taken the alpha value from data handbook. Again, it is taken from the data handbook. Property values of a material. I don't know where it is given in the data, but anyhow, it is taken from data handbook only. And this value is 8.418 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter square, and T naught is 126. And these two values are taken from data handbook. I am going to make, I am not referred this, I am referring different data handbook for solving this problem. But anyhow, most of the students heard that you are going to measure Kodan Raman. That is why I am referring to this Kodan Raman. So these are the initial and ambient temperature, and R naught is equal to 0.1 meter. This is also, and H value is given. Therefore, you have to calculate the temperature distribution directly, because the known temperatures are given. This distribution value is 0.3. So then again, you have to 1 by byte, you have to calculate K by H naught is equal to 2.4 from Heisler chart 4.98. Means you have to take directly the temperature distribution, and H by value, you can calculate the time duration from this, because any two values are given and third value from 4 years, you can calculate the time domain. So that is how the axis of the cylinder reaches 126 degrees Celsius after 184 seconds. It means how you calculated this is, cylinder radius is 0.1 centimeter is given. It means that radius r I have taken here as 0.1 here. Okay, this is the k by h r naught. R naught is equal to 0.1. From Euler charts, we are going to calculate this. So by using these two time domain, how do you calculate this? I am going to show you. No, it is not there. One problem I chose one. So I am going to write it on the board. Okay. For a long cylinder.
I'm going to write the graph how I have taken that. I'm going to show it now, because otherwise it's very difficult to for you to understand.
This you calculated, no? This you already know. No? The data is taken from the data handbook, and T0 minus T infinity.
T0 minus T infinity and Ti minus T infinity. So this how much you get? After substituting value, you will get 0.3. So from the graph, I tried to manipulate all the, so I am going to write this down. So these are the lines. Okay, here it is.
I'm sorry, temperature line.
The graphs which are shown like this, this is the graph. Another one is finally which I am going to get this, and one more line it is like this. So these are the different value lines for H R naught by K. H R naught by K is equal to Biot number. Okay, this is the Biot number line. I think I'll make appropriate justification. This is a 4 years number. 4 years number. It can be called as tau. It cannot be taken as alpha tau by R naught. Alpha tau by R naught. These are the values. And here you'll get a temperature distribution. Theta T by theta.
So now you already, this is a 0.3 is here. Temperature distribution I have taken 0.3 here. From this, the Biot number which I calculated. One by Biot is calculated. In this Biot number is there. 1 by 2.4, almost 1 by 2 means 0.5. Okay, you have to take this as a Biot number of 0.5. This is 0.5 Biot number. From this you have to draw a line, and where it get intersect, first line is at 0.3, you have to draw a line. So this is temperature distribution 0.3, and after that you take the 4 year line. So this 4 year number you have to note down. See the how to start, calculate the temperature distribution equal to 0.3, Biot number is equal to 0.5, and then take down. Here I used a inverse graph, that is why I taken Biot number 1 by Biot is equal to 2.4. So from Euler charts. Okay. See this tau value you are going to get tau value at this point is 1.55. So from using this 1.55, using temperature at 0.3 and K is equal to 2.04. So R K is equal to K by H R naught is equal to 2.4. That's 1 by Biot. So now I convert this 1 by 2 means almost 0.5 something. That I have taken. And now we have to calculate the
4 years number is this 1.55. You have to calculate from this alpha tau divided by R naught is equal to 1.55. You can calculate the temperature T. Say time T is equal to 1.55 R naught by alpha.
You will get the time domain that is equal to 184
seconds. 184 seconds. The time you are going to get.
It is at what distance? It is at a distance of, it is at the center of the axis, at the center of the, or the center of the cylinder, or on the axis of the cylinder. This is the temperature, 126 degrees Celsius. How you have taken 126? Because he has asked you to calculate the time domain to reach in order to reach 126 degrees Celsius. That is what he has given. How you have taken that? That you have taken here, the essential temperature at the center. So now, that problem is over. Now the long aluminum cylinder of radius, that's what I take now, okay. See, one more problem, similar problem I'm going to take here. A long cylinder of radius 10 centimeter, which is initially at a uniform, same problem? Yeah, same problem I taken. But time domain is given at 20 cylinder exposed to the environment. Same problem is re-altered and the heat transfer coefficient is the time is given now to calculate the temperature. So this is what, same problem. Dimension looks similar, but the heat transfer coefficient is totally different. There 1000 taken, here 600 are taken. Calculate the temperature at the radius R 6 centimeter. And the heat transfer per meter length of the cylinder at 120 seconds after the cylinder is exposed to the environment. It means previous example I calculated the time duration. Now in this example I am going to calculate the what is the temperature after 120 seconds. Now we have to calculate. See, these are the properties taken from the data handbook. These are the properties for aluminium 204. And our diffusivity also taken, conductivity is, this density also taken from data handbook, CP value is also taken from the data handbook. Because it is not given here, if it is not given that, you should not take from the data handbook. You can also take all the values from data handbook at the maximum temperature of 350. Okay. So now, similar way you have to calculate the 4 years number, Boyard number, and also the R by R naught value, and from graph determine the temperature at the axis of the cylinder using Eisler charts. These are the variables that I calculated in order to refer. See, I am always taking one by Boyard. In this graph it is given only Boyard, and the value will not alter, but only thing is that you have to adapt to this and problems are solved. I am referring that Nakati was a sick book and I am referring these problems. So here in this, if you are referring these graphs, you have to use these property values and then calculate the 4 years number, Boyard number and R by R naught value, that is position, and take the whatever quantity you want to calculate and then substitute it. So how do I determine this? For 4 year number you have to take and temperature distribution will get 0.65. In 4 year number you will get 1.01 and 1 by Boyard is 3.4 from figure, and it is to be calculated like that. So I will take the same graphs and I will try to solve one problem from this. To next class I am going to show you that. Thank you very much.